good morning. And now mornings are a beautiful time, especially if you're a new mother. The house is filled with sounds of laughter and joy, and you can't just wait to see your baby. Even if she or he has kept you up all night, you get up from your bed, and before you could even walk to the glass of water, you feel your weight. You see yourself in the mirror and the heart sinks. The C-section that you underwent wasn't really flattering to your figure. And now, the morning suddenly feels very gloomy. If that's you, then don't worry. We'll never let your mornings turn gloomy. Namaste, my name is Sumisha and I'm a teacher at the Yoga Institute. And here, we are on a mission to turn your mornings truly into a good morning. Gaining weight during pregnancy is absolutely normal. However, if even after your delivery you gain any weight, you should be able to start reducing within 6 months of delivery. So now, if your doctor has given you clearance, which is very important, let's hit the mat and get to work. The first thing what you can do is to walk around the house. You should always remember to be gentle on yourself, but gentleness will bring activeness in your body. You need to remain active, your joints to be supple, your body's energies to be moving. That's why our guru Hansaji talks about walking in and around the house. And you can also tie a dupatta around your navel to keep your body in shape and let the body know that, yes, it's okay, it's fine, and you're going to be completely normal, healthy, and back to your shape. The second technique, what we are going to do today, is Parvat Asana, the mountain pose. So here, this is a sitting mountain pose. Since you are a new mother, if you're a beginner in the world of yoga, so please keep a rolled mat and sit over it so that you're supported on your spine. And when you sit, ensure that your legs are firmly grounded on the Mother Earth and you're taking support from the earth. Always remember that you need to be supported while you begin your journey of a good, healthy body. So we will begin. All you have to do is that sit in Sukhasana, meaning easy pose, cross-leg pose. If you're an advanced learner, you can go into a half lotus or a full lotus, meaning Ardha Padmasana or full Padmasana. So we will begin by putting our hands to our side. And since we are going against the gravity, we will breathe in very softly. And we'll just go raise our hands and put it in a namaste and stay there and try to put our shoulder blades back and our shoulders are not shrinking like this. They are completely relaxed as long as you can go like here, here, here. It's okay. Just feel the uplift here from the abdominal area below your navel. And this is where the anti-aging yoga starts. You breathe in as per your capacity, pretty normal, one or two odd breaths, and then slowly exhaling, you completely come down and relax. So the intention or the bhava which you will have is to know your body. So while you go up, this is the gyan bhava, and you're going to be completely surrendering to the body and know that your body is going to heal. So that's how it is a gyan bhava. If you have too much of tight shoulders or frozen shoulders, you have to do shoulder loosening exercises before you try out this Parvatasana. The third technique is the sleeping fish pose called the Supta Matsyasana. So let's get started on this. The easiest way is to completely lie on the ground, tilting towards one side and coming to the ground, relieving every tension in the body. And very gently folding your legs into Sukhasana or an easy pose like this. Easy breezy till wherever you are, you can be. If your hamstrings are very tight or quadriceps are very tight, you can put up some pillows there and just release this thighs towards the ground. And now slowly inhale and clasp your hands on your elbows and just adjusting your shoulder blades. We stay here for 1 to 2 minutes, breathing normally, and with every exhale, becoming comfortable with our body and with our posture. Once you are done, You unclasp your hands, bring back your hands near your body, straighten your legs completely, roll to one side, and taking the support, come into your Sukhasana pose. So this simple asana, if you stay there for 1 to 2 odd minutes, you will be able to harness a lot of benefits. Specifically after a C-section, your pelvic area, your ovaries needs to get strengthened. The blood circulation needs to be redirected to your lower abdominal area and to your uterus. Apart from toning your abdominal muscles, putting the space in your pelvic area, it helps your ovaries to get back to their shape. So that is why the sleeping fish pose is a must for every new mother. If you have frozen shoulders and severe arthritis, that is a contraindication for this pose. Otherwise, you're good to go. Being a mother means being a multitasker. The techniques that we shared with you are not only easy to do, but also manageable between your now super busy schedule and help you become the goddess that you are. Now the moment that all of us wait for. Time to hear it from our guru and guiding light, Hansaji, lovingly known as Ma.
Namaskar. In woman's life, motherhood is an absolute shift from her normal life. She once become mother, she is totally a responsible woman, totally sensitive woman, caring woman, forgets about her needs, her comforts, totally taking care of child, and she goes through quite a lot of hormonal imbalance in her body. She has no sleep pattern, no eating food on time, sleeping on time, doing anything on time, not possible, time is gone. And with child, it is demand and supply. Child demands food, you have to supply. Child demands attention, time, you have to supply. So whole life is rotating around baby now. This is very, very difficult, but definitely manageable, and it is very beautiful also. Since there are no hormones secreting well in her body, no sleep well, her body is going through quite a lot of upheaval. Body becomes heavy, body becomes sluggish, body starts putting on weight, and you feel that you are very heavy and weak. This makes her movements also very slow, but she has to carry on. So here I would give you a few tips which person should understand. First, learn to sleep as much as possible, because you need a good sleep and good secretion of hormones. Whenever baby sleeps, you sleep. Whenever baby gets up, you get up. Your life is totally around baby. Master this art and you will feel so refreshed and fine. Try and you will succeed. Second point, your body needs a perfect nutrition. Because of all these things, you have lost quite a lot of blood, lost quite a lot of your strength. You have to pick up. In Indian culture, lots of varieties are cooked during this time, and they are really very tasty and very wholesome food. And so you should be careful. You should eat those things, but very little in quantity. You should definitely have hunger, otherwise don't eat. And even all these products which you like to munch and all that, which are unhealthy, should not be taken. If woman has gas, child will have gas and child will be in trouble. If woman has cold, child will get cold. Woman has to be extra careful what she is eating, how much she is eating, and so on. Third point, woman should have lots of liquids because she is lactating, breastfeeding baby. And so with meal also you should have glass full of liquids, and in between also should have little water all the time. Fourth point, she should be walking as much as possible, because this is the only thing which will save your body, which will keep your body slim and trim. Because walking is mildest and best exercise. You cannot do heavy exercises. You should do asanas, which we have shown. Fifth point, you should take care of your psychology. It is quite common for working women to get into depression when you are going through this phase. It is postpartum depression. She starts throwing temper tantrums. She gets angry, she gets frustrated. And you should know that if you get angry and frustrated, the milk of yours would be so-called poisonous. That milk is going to hurt your child. Child will have loose motion. Child will have running nose. You should be careful. So look at baby. This is a new life. every moment some or other new things are happening with a child. It's like a miracle. Baby is like a god in the house. So try and take care of your emotions. Don't allow any negativity. Don't even think about yourself, what you want. Now you don't want anything, baby is there. Don't even look at your body. Body is right now heavy, but it will become normal. I guarantee you that once you start stopping your lactation, breastfeeding baby, then you can start with some exercise a little more and basically asanas more. And very soon your body will become perfect, slim, trim, shining and beautiful. So enjoy the pride of motherhood. Namaskar.
Thank you, Ma, for your kind and encouraging words. Hope you have already started following these techniques so that not only you are the best version of yourself, but also the best you could possibly be for your child. If you enjoyed watching this video, do hit the like button, share it with your friends and family who need to deal with post-pregnancy issues. Comment down below, and if you have any issue that you would like us to address, and last but not the least, subscribe to the Yoga Institute and press the bell icon to get notified of our shows. We'll be back every weekday at 7:30 a.m. Until then, good morning and have a lovely and a wonderful day.